Good evening, Americans, and welcome to The Ed Show tonight from New York. Mitt Romney is struggling in the polls in his home state of Michigan. Seems like the state hasn't forgotten that he was against the automobile loan that helped save the auto industry in big cities like Detroit. How can you be against jobs? Just be a Republican. This is The Ed Show. Let's get to work.
If you just write a check, that you're going to see these companies go out of business ultimately.
Mitt Romney is selling used cars in Michigan, and the people aren't buying it. Richard Wolf has the latest on the Romney spiral and the Santorum surge. 15 days before your taxes go up, the president was out hammering Republicans today.
Pass this middle class tax cut. Pass the extension of unemployment insurance. Do it before it's too late.
Congresswoman Jan Schakowsky and Jonathan Alter will tell us where the payroll tax cut fight stands. Scott Walker and President Obama are set to meet face-to-face in Milwaukee tomorrow. We'll have a preview. And Apple is launching an investigation into inhumane working conditions in Chinese factories.
I own an iPhone, and when I use it, I'm reminded of the children who put devices together.
Author Mike Daisy's off-Broadway performance shines a light on the problem, and he's here tonight. Great to have you with us tonight, folks. Thanks for watching. Mitt Romney is desperate to win the upcoming Michigan primary. But Michigan isn't about to forget how Mitt Romney wanted to deal with Detroit back in 2008. Romney is blanketing the airwaves with a new ad portraying him as the favorite son of Michigan and protector of the automobile industry.
Now, when I grew up in Michigan, it was exciting to be here. I remember going to the Detroit Auto Show with my dad. That was a big deal. How in the world did an industry and its leaders and its unions get in such a fix that they lost jobs, that they lost their future? President Obama did all these things the liberals have wanted to do for years. And the fact that you've got millions of Americans out of work, home values collapsing, people here in Detroit are distressed. I want to make Michigan stronger and better. Michigan's been my home, and this is personal. I'm Mitt Romney, and I approve this message.
Holy smokes. When it comes to the recovery of the United States automobile industry, Romney still refuses to give the President of the United States and the taxpayers any credit whatsoever. In an op-ed in today's Detroit News, Romney wrote this about the government auto loan. Instead of the free market doing what it does best, we got a major taste of crony capitalism, Obama style. It's easy to be confused. A month ago, Romney was saying the auto loan bailout succeeded because President Obama took his advice.
The president ultimately did what I suggested, going through a managed bankruptcy process. I wrote an op-ed about this.
Of course, Romney's famous advice was to let Detroit go bankrupt. You know, back in 2008, the New York Times op-ed, Romney wrote this. You can kiss the American automobile industry goodbye. And its demise will be virtually guaranteed. He wasn't shy back then about telling everyone how badly a government loan would fail.
There's no question but that if you just write a check, that you're going to see these companies go out of business ultimately. Instead, we have to help these companies restructure, stay in business, but restructure, shed the unnecessary costs, make them competitive with the transplants and the foreign cars, and by virtue of doing that, make sure they stay in business long term.
All right, let's get back to where we exactly are. Romney said a loan to the auto industry would put car companies out of business. That's what he said. He said the auto industry was eventually saved because the president took his advice. And now he says the loan was successful in spite of President Obama's crony capitalism. My friends, here are the facts. This is what you need to know. Chrysler increased sales by 26% last year. Now, I don't know what the Bain experience here is, but 26% increase, is that not even good enough at Bain? General Motors sales up 13%. By the way, GM is the number one producer in the world. You mean to tell me as Americans and as a man who wants to be president of the United States, he's embarrassed to say that GM is number one at producing vehicles on the face of the earth? Talk about apologies. The companies have also added 115,000 jobs. Think about how many homes were saved that Mitt Romney's driving by in his commercial. These are all good things for the people of Michigan and for America. Mitt Romney's all wrong on the auto loan, and he's suffering in his home state because of it. You know, Mitt, why don't you try this angle when it comes to talking about the automobile loan? I would have had some differences on how they did it, but I'm not going to second guess it. The most important thing is the results, and the auto industry is doing very well today. You know, those aren't my words. Those are straight from the Republican governor of the state of Michigan, Rick Snyder. I mean, the Republicans are in denial about what has happened here. Maybe Romney wouldn't be trailing Rick Santorum by some 15 points in Michigan in his home state if he took maybe a positive approach. Say, like, well, there's 115 different ways to skin a cat, and I would have skinned it differently. Well, no, that wouldn't have been good because he's got this dog story out there, so leave the cat out of it. That's not good advice. Maybe he should say it's good to add jobs in America, and it's good that people are still in their homes, and we're glad to see GM number one and all the sales going through the roof, but I would have done it differently. That's all he had to do. The Obama administration and the American people stepped forward and saved this industry. No question about it. Mitt Romney turned his back on his home state, and he wants to know why he's trailing by 15 points in his home state. You see, his advice was to walk. President Obama's guts told him to stand with the workers. But look where we are right now. We have the Republican Party, supposedly a guy who was supposed to have this thing wrapped up a long time ago. He's out there bad-mouthing economic success in his own home state. How do you think independent voters in Michigan are going to feel when they see Mitt Romney saying this, that, when it comes to the automobile industry? Look, this was good for America, and I would hate to see this country now devolve into a conversation where it's bad when we add jobs. It's bad when we save homes. I noticed that he picked on the unions in that commercial. Mr. Romney, I'd like you to be very open and honest about what the unions have actually done to save the automobile industry in Detroit and other parts of the Rust Belt. They took a haircut. They took a big haircut. And the wages that they have right now aren't anywhere near what they used to be because they wanted to see it succeed. They also took hits in their health care and in their pension. And it's a little bit different on that assembly line today than it was years ago. The American workers have stepped up in a big, big way. And it's unfortunate that the Republican Party is saying that adding jobs is a bad thing in the automobile industry because they didn't do it the Republican way. Yeah, the Bain way. Give me a break. You want to know why the guy's getting his butt kicked in his home state? Because he's not honest. He's not honest with the economic facts of what's happening with this economy, and you can just see the jealousy drip off him in his commercials. You know, Mitt Romney would be a horrible candidate if he didn't have a bunch of money to spend on TV ads. I mean, if it was just Santorum and Romney standing there with nothing but what they believe in, Romney would be out to lunch big time, and he wouldn't know how to pay for it. Speaking of paying for stuff, think about this. The automobile loan is being paid back. It's fiscally responsible. And the Republicans are against that, too? Get your cell phones out. Want to know what you think. Tonight's question. Would a loss in Michigan effectively end Mitt Romney's campaign? Text A for yes. Text B for no to 622-639. You can always go to our blog at ed.msnbc.com. We'll bring you the results later on in the show. Joining me now is Congressman Gary Peters of Michigan. Congressman, good to have you with us tonight. I appreciate your time.
Well, it's always a pleasure to be with you, Ed.
Well, I want to take you back to what was written today. We know it was written by Mitt Romney back in 2008, as we just showed it to you, but he's still at it. He says today, instead of the free market doing what it does best, we got a major taste of crony capitalism Obama style. What's your response to that?
Well, he just doesn't know what he's talking about, and he's really forgetting a lot of history about what was happening back in 2009. As Chrysler and General Motors were heading towards bankruptcy, there simply wasn't private capital available to get out of the bankruptcy. Mitt Romney says you should have gone to the private markets. Well, he has to remember that Wall Street was frozen. We just got through this debacle on Wall Street where greed went wild, the markets had collapsed. There simply wasn't money available, particularly in the billions of dollars necessary for both Chrysler and General Motors. In fact, I sat in the boardroom with Mr. Nardelli, who was the CEO of Chrysler at the time, and he said, Congressman, if we don't have federal loans, we will not have the money necessary to get through bankruptcy and to restructure. The private markets are simply not there for us. I'm going to be forced to liquidate this company. And if Mr. Romney had his way, that's exactly what happened. These companies would have liquidated, and with that, hundreds of thousands of jobs would have been lost, not just in Michigan, but all across the country, not just with the two major companies, but also with all the auto suppliers that supply parts to those major companies.
Is there any downside to what has transpired in the automobile industry? Look at the other side of the spectrum, what the Republicans are talking about. Where's the downside? I'm looking for it. Where is it?
I don't see the downside, Ed. I mean, we've saved a critical industry, which is all about American manufacturing, and these are great middle-class jobs that are being saved as a result of that. Jobs are being added. In fact, you know, I was just at a meeting back in Michigan earlier in the week, and I had auto suppliers telling me that they're in a situation right now where they can't find enough people, enough engineers. They're hiring people, and they can't find enough people. 2 years ago, those same companies were laying off people. Now they're in the position where they're hiring and they're looking for even more, period. This is a great success story. We've got to remind everybody of the success story about President Obama taking a risk. He took an awful lot of heat from around the country to make this decision, but it was the right decision. And it's always right to bet on the American workers, because every time they will do it, especially the men and women of the UAW who made significant sacrifices and are now building world-class cars. And in fact, in my district, they're building a car that General Motors thought they could only build profitably in China. That's the Chevy Sonic. It's being built in Michigan with UAW labor, and it's being made at a profit. It is a great American success story.
Your colleague, Republican Congressman Bill Huizenga of Michigan, is, of course, a Romney supporter. Right. But he said something very interesting about the candidate. About Romney, he said, it'd be a huge embarrassment if he's not able to win the Michigan primary. Is this really going to be the thorn in his side in Michigan if he doesn't come to grip with how positive this has been? Because it would seem to me that the independent voters are going to be honest brokers when it comes to what's economically good. And now you really have a chance of seeing Mitt Romney losing to Rick Santorum in Michigan. Sort that out for us.
Well, I think it'd be a devastating blow. I don't pretend to know Republican politics and primary politics, but here is a man who says that he was raised in Michigan, he has Michigan values, he understands the auto industry, and yet when the auto industry really needed help, he wasn't there. In fact, he said, let the auto industry go bankrupt, let it disappear. If the government supports this industry, it would be a mistake. Well, he was proven wrong. And had he been president at the time, it would have been catastrophic, not just for my state, but for the whole country.
Congressman Gary Peters, great to have you with us tonight, telling the story. Thanks so much.
Appreciate it, Ed. Thank you.
You bet. Remember to answer tonight's question there at the bottom of the screen. Share your thoughts on Twitter at Ed Show. We want to know what you think. President Obama had Republicans on the ropes, and they agreed to pass the extension of the payroll tax cut, but the fight is far from over. Congresswoman Jan Schakowsky will join me on that. And later, the president, and believe it or not, Wisconsin Governor Scott Walker will meet in Milwaukee tomorrow. John Nichols is here to preview Walker's Jan Brewer moment. Stay with us.